I grew up attending Sunday school and knowing who this person of Jesus was, but never truly believing and was never convicted that I needed God in my life. And it was only when God met me at a point in my life where I felt very broken and very lost that I truly came to faith. And He did so quite uniquely. I remember one Sunday morning deciding to come to church and taking that step of faith to attend service. And in the lift, this stranger struck up a conversation with me because she saw that I had pressed the wrong button to the wrong floor and asked if I wanted to go for the English service instead, and asked me and invited me to sit with her friends. And since then, Xiaomin slowly reached out to me, and over time, I came to know of the truth of God's word, and slowly my heart softened, and I remembered making that decision to really believe in Jesus.
I was born into a Christian family, and I was actually baptized 20 years ago. However, at the initial point of baptism, I think I did not truly understand. So fast forward 20 years later, through the various preaching that I've heard from GLCC, primarily through Pastor Jason's sermons, through the various books I've read, God revealed certain truths in His Word to me. God's Word has truly touched my heart, has begun a work of faith in me, and I believe now that I'm saved.
I found myself wanting to know more about His Word, and I found myself wanting and looking forward to coming to church every Sunday. And this was so ironic because what was once so boring and so meaningless to me suddenly became so exciting and real.
The Lord has sent joy to fill my heart. So this joy from above eradicates all the emptiness that I feel in my soul. Whereas in the past, I was trying to labor based on my own strength. I was sinning and failing and sinning and failing. But now the Lord has sent His Holy Spirit to dwell in my heart. And the Holy Spirit gives me the strength to carry out God's commands.
God is always faithfully there. No matter how far away He is from us, He's always working and using all our experiences, whether they are good or bad, and making them beautiful in His time. I think God just wants us to open that little bit of our hearts for Him, to fill it with His love and fill it with His grace.
The Bible tells us that we are more than conquerors through Christ. So I know that although I'm still faced with sin, I'm still faced with temptations and trials, but I know I can overcome all these obstacles through the power of Christ that lives in me.